Okay, so how about if I try to explain DiHybrid crosses? So usually the way I learn is I doodle and I don't just read. So I just explained it to myself for about the fifth time by doodling. And may I share my doodles with you? Let's have a look here. All right, so I like to think by doodling. I'm a doodler. Now, some websites, some teachers, there's a zillion ways to explain DiHybrid crosses, but some teachers teach it with this foil method. Do you remember doing foil in grade 9? Right? First, outer, inner, last. So I'll just show you this in case you remember doing that stuff. So here's the one way they show how to combine the letters to make different combinations. When you're reproducing. So it's pretty much like grade 9 foil. How to multiply two binomials together. Do you remember doing that? You probably don't, right? You probably hated that. Oh, but anyway, let's not do it that way. But you might remember it that way. Let's try a different way. I only thought of this morning, all right? So let's share dinner. Here's the menu. Look. Today's menu. You can select one main item. Here's your main items. And one side item. All right. So I hear the big A is pretty good today. It's roasted to perfection. Or the other main choice is little A. That's a bit recessive, but it's very popular. Or you got your choices, kind of like your vegetables. Right? You could get big B, it's imported. Or you might decide to have little B, it's another good choice. All right, so each of those is your possible choices. So, you're going to hook up with your partner there and you're going to go have dinner and you're going to share your dinner. See what could happen. Let's do that. So let's go to dinner and share. All right, so let's say you choose, you got two choices, right? You could take big A or little A. And you can pick big B or little B. So you get to have one of the main course and one of the side item. And your partner's going to pick one of the main course and one of the side item. But notice, she doesn't like big B's. So she says, I'm not eating none of that big B stuff. So it's just like ordering on a dinner menu and sharing with your partner. So your main item is the A's. Your side item is the B's. Your partner has to select the main item. And there's not much choice in her side item. There's no way she's eating a big B. She hates big B's. All right, so then, what could possibly happen? All right, so you, say this is you on this side, you could have a big A and a big B. Or you might say, no, tell you what, I'll have a big A and a little B instead. And then you say, well, no, you know what, that little A sure looks good for the main course. Maybe I'll have a little A. And, how about a big B? You know what? I'm not sure what I want. Maybe I'll have the little A with the little B. Yeah, so many possible choices. Wow. Maybe I'll just get the waiter to surprise me. Ha, ha, ha. All right. How about you, my dear? What are you going to have? Oh, so your partner says, well, what are her choices? So she says, let's see, I got to pick a main, I got to pick a side. There's my main, there's a sub, right? There's not a lot of choice in the sides, because I only eat little B's. So her choices there are, let's see, big A, little B, or big A, little B, right? So, yeah, it was, her second choice was the same as her first choice. Or she might pick the little A, that looked kind of enticing, with the little B. And, of course, she had two choices that were the same. Let's see what happens now when we share and combine our meals. How many different combinations could we possibly get served? Are you following all this? I copied this. All right, so this was your possible choices. This was your partner's possible choices. Let's see what happens. Here we go. What gets delivered to the table? There's four choices times four choices. There's 16 possible choices. Right? Because you got four choices, and your partner has four choices, and four times four is 16. Even if a couple of them are the same for the partner. So you're allowed to have a couple choices the same. You don't have to eat the big B. Nobody likes big B. All right, so you have four choices. Your partner has four choices. You know, you might go zoom, 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 or you might go zoom, 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 or you'll see what's going to happen here. Stand by. Let's animate all those possibilities. Are you ready? So what could possibly be brought to the table? All right. So here's me. I offer to order a big B. And if we partner that up with you, if I get a big A big B and you get a big A little B, or a little A big B, what are the possibilities? All right, so I think you can follow this. I'm not going to explain it step by step. Just follow what happens here. If you have to pause this movie and do a screenshot, try that. Okay, so let me explain that maybe. So maybe I had a big A, big B delivered to the table. And you had... Oh, I gotta wake up. And you had a... And your partner had a big B. I'm sorry. And your partner had a big A, little B delivered to the table. So this was one of your possible choices. This was one of your partner's possible choices. So it turns out that when you combine your meals, you'll have two orders of big A, an order of big B, and an order of little B. Well, that's a nice variety. Right? So there's how that all works, right? Boom, 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 boom. Notice we're going to have 16 different possibilities. Turns out that half of them are the same. So here's the possible combinations of meals that can be delivered to your table. Notice what I did there, eh? Normally when you have a little A, big A, normally you put the big A in front and it just makes it easier so you don't get confused. Because a big A, little A is the same as a little A, big A. It's the same combination. It's just, it makes more sense to put them in the same order. So put the big letter first. And here comes the last four choices, four combinations. There you go. So you had four choices. Your partner had four choices, even though two of them were pretty much the same because she doesn't like big B's. And you ended up with 16 combinations. Notice that some of them are the same. Let me explain that here. Stand by. So yes, notice that some of your partner's choices were the same. She would never choose Big B. She never had a Big B to offer. She never brought a Big B to the table. She didn't have a Big B in her alleles, in her chromosomes, in her genes. So she couldn't possibly offer up a Big B. It wasn't even a choice. So it turns out there wasn't 16 different combinations, there was only 8 different combinations. In this case, sometimes you get 16 combinations. Sometimes you only get one. All right. And then I got silly and I thought, oh, I'll just put some clip art in here. All right. So let's explain it this way. All right. So here's a guy and a girl. They're going to go out to dinner. They're going to order meals. All right. Let's see if this explains it better. Let's share our dinners. Okay. I'll have big A with little B. Or maybe I'll have little A with little B. I hate big B's. Hey, waiter, surprise me. So there's her choices. She could have big A for the main with little B for the side. Or she might have little A for the main and little B for the side. Notice she hates big B. She's not even offering to order that. And she says, surprise me, server. And then, of course, the guy says, well, I like everything on this. I don't know what to pick. I'll have A, B, or, well, correction, big A, big B, or big A, little B. Or maybe I'll have little A, big B, or maybe I'll have little A, little B. I don't know. I'm not fussy, though. So those are my possibilities. Surprise me. Go ahead, wait. Go ahead, server, surprise me. Just bring me whatever you want. All right, so what are the possible combinations we get at our table? What are the possible combinations we get when we share? There you go. So notice there was 8 combinations. Normally there's 16. But because she was extra fussy and doesn't have any big B's to offer when we share our meals, there's only going to be 8 combinations. So we have 8 different possible combinations we could share. Too bad she didn't like big B. We could have had 16 combinations. Anyway, I was just having a bit of fun there trying to explain this for the 5th time in my head, how DiHybrid crosses work. That's called doodling and thinking, and that's the best way to learn. And you should be learning forever. Complete.